So I have the RM1X here. This guy is currently sequencing its own drum sounds internally. The MS-101 and the DW-8000. Those two via MIDI on channels 1 for this guy and 16 for this guy. And then I've got the DW-8000 going through the wedge to get some flange. Those go into channel 1 and 2. The MS-101 goes into channels 1 and 2 as well, basically in mono. And then the RM1X comes out into the modular, goes through the antiphon, the Erebus, and then into the little mini clouds there. And that goes into 3 and 4, which you can see peaking currently. I do some filtering in little Erebus. And that is gated via the MS-101's baseline. You can currently see the clock is coming in here, and it kind of goes a little bit crazy. So cool. So for a better explanation here, let's follow the signal. I take the mono output of the RM1X, and that goes into the external in of the antiphon. I take that out to a little splitter here. Originally I was splitting the signal to go into rings for my previous jam, but I decided against that this time. I take it into the audio input of little Erebus, right here. The envelope for this filter cutoff is being generated by contour 1. Contour 2, I think, is currently still going to the rings, so unused. And contour 3 is essentially a constant steady gate high, and that is used to keep the VCA on the little Erebus from closing ever. This is then taken out, is fed into the Lifeform's dual VCA. I'm boosting that up just a little bit there, and that goes into the mono input of Microburst. Microburst itself is being clocked, triggered, via channel 1 here on the T side. The X side is basically modulating various parameters on the Microburst to give it like this live choppy feel almost. Mute our two other instruments, but this is just the wet sounds. And then if we bring this back, blend is also being modulated by the X side here, which are using the Erebus, or rather the Dreadbox attenuators, and I'm kind of calming down the plus or minus 5 volts from that. Make sure the DBX is turned on here. DBX is. And then that's looking good. Make sure that this can't be rewound anymore. Reset the counter. And then I guess go ahead and record there. And then I don't know. Do I want to record here maybe too? Maybe I'll bounce this back out to that later. Cool. So that's going good. Levels look fine. Alright, here we go.